Hey guys, so we have some exciting news. We're off on our way to Toronto to pick up an industrial robot arm. Got a trailer behind the truck and it's gonna be awesome.
Well, they have four car batteries stuck.
What are those things?
Your destination is on the left.
Big shout out to Air Molded Plastics for giving us an awesome deal on the six-axis robot arm. So we picked up the robot arm and it's tied down the trailer pretty good. Hopefully it doesn't fall off. We basically paid the scrap metal value of a robot arm that when it was new, probably would have cost more than a car. I hope we can get it up and running because we have some awesome plans for it. So a little history on the actual robot arm. It used to, in its previous life, was used as a foam injection robot for putting the insulation into thermos coolers, which is actually kind of cool. This company picked it up a while ago with an intentions to fix it up and use it, but that never happened and they decided to just get rid of it, which is where we found it on Kijiji. We just made a pit stop for lunch and to double check all the chains and the ratchet straps on the robot, and one was loose, so we're actually going to stop at Lowe's now and pick up a few more ratchet straps just to make sure this thing is not going anywhere, because that would suck if it tipped over. And we still have another hour and a half to drive, so we want to make sure everything's tied down. All right, let's get going.
How are we getting it down the driveway?
No, I wouldn't park it on that angle, no. Plan is get the pallet truck underneath. Oh, is it gonna fit?
Sure it will.
Because we can move the controller around and we could come from this side, the other side, but that's not gonna fit, is it? Yeah, the pallet truck doesn't fit. Just be careful this doesn't start tipping it. It's tipping slightly,
yeah,
but...
if we can even like, yeah, no,
go ahead, what?
No, do what you're doing.
Maybe not. I don't know. Just by yourself, no problem.
That's the new guy.
No, no, I mean...
Okay, okay. Alright, it moves, it moves.
You see it drop. It's way heavy on this side, eh?
It's just way heavy.
Chain around it. Probably a bit higher up, attached to the winch, and then keep it tight. Then this trailer actually tips. We might want to call Stan over just to double check we know how the tipping feature works. I'm gonna call Stan and see if he wants to come over. That'd be good. So the other kind of issue, the pump cart, the style skid, it won't fit in the middle. Hang on. This looks really tippy and this chain is not tight. That concerns me.
It did come up a little bit.
So, according to the instruction manual, the machine was built in 1990. Last time it was used, probably over 5 years, I want to say. I don't want any of the fans getting their hopes up. If we get this thing running, it's not going to happen overnight. It could be weeks or even months from now, because we have quite a few issues that we have to solve. First of all, it didn't even come with the cables to connect the robot to the controller, and those are pretty expensive, so we're not sure if we want to buy those right away. So yeah, we're going to try and locally source some used cables for it. The next major issue we have is this is a 480-volt three-phase machine. We do not have 480 volts three-phase here. We don't even have 480 volts. But because it's a robot arm, there's a chance we might be able to cheat and use a transformer to take 240 to 480 and feed that in on one phase. It depends if this had many safety systems in place. If not, we're going to have to get a three-phase converter or build our own. So there's a whole bunch of projects that have to go on before we can even test this to see if it works. But we're going to do our best, and worst case, I'm quite happy to have paid $500 for something to put on my lawn.
Okay, well,
as always, thanks for watching. We're working on tons of projects right now, and if you can't wait every week for a video, don't forget to follow us on social media, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, or you can even chat with us one-on-one on our Discord private chat room. So click the links in the description below and start following us. Thanks again.